All right, welcome back, F1 Manager Nation. This is your buddy, F1 Manager Legend, with another installment. And I wish I would have done a video. Wait, hold on. I wish I would have done a video of me qualifying. As you can see, this is my F1 Ford Racing account. I am a contender 3. Someone asked to see who I'm racing up against and stuff like that. If any of you see my, if any of you see your name, let me know. Alright, so, as you can see, I got a legendary crate. Psych! The cool thing about the daily crates is when you're first starting, they're actually worth something. Once you start maxing out parts and drivers, the only thing these free crates are worth is just the coins and the dollars, or the bucks, or whatever they're called. And here it is. Look at that thing. Isn't that beautiful? Okay, awesome. Danny Rick. Boy, those legendary crates are nice at the beginning of the game. Okay, so let's go see what we got. So, as you can see, his stats are not good. His consistency, fuel management, and tire management are way too low. So, he's not going to be usable for a while. I think once he gets to, like, level 4, he becomes pretty good. So, I was using Perez. And I switched over to Grosjean. The fuel management is not that... Well, actually, the fuel management for Grosjean is pretty good. So Grosjean and Norris, they are pretty comparable right now. And Grosjean's only, I think, level 4? Oh, let me see. Oh, sorry, Grosjean's a level 7. So by the time he gets level 10, Grosjean's going to be really good. I don't know if anybody gets better than him, but on my main account, I still use him. So I am using now Grosjean and Norris. I was using Perez, but his consistency was good, but everything else was not that good. So those are the two drivers. Lando Norris has a hard time overtaking, and you will see how that affects him. And we got the Shredder. Okay, let's see if I can use it. Nope, still can't use it. I went through, oh, that's the other thing I should have did. I actually went through and I changed my parts all around. And I think I made my car a little bit better. But that's my setup, that's what I'm running. This is where all my parts are at. You guys can pause it if you need to look a little bit longer. All right, there's my setup. Let's get to the racing. Here's everyone in my group. Oops, stop doing that. Okay. So in case you guys didn't know, when you're on the screen, if you click, it'll bring up your stats for all the races. Alright, we found a match. We're going racing. We are in China. This is a kind of a tricky track. There's two places where your drivers will go off the course here. And Grosjean tends to go off a lot. Right here, you can go off. right there you can go off. Okay, so he's using the strategy. Alejandro Gaspariano. So all you guys wanted to see what happens when you start at the back. Okay, let's see if Norris is going to lose it. No, he made it. Good pass. You can see whoever was in 14th went off the track there. Now, this next area right here, see how Grosjean handles it. Stayed on the track that time. Awesome. Awesome. Whew, man. After those first pit stops. Grosjean is in dead last. Did he go off the track? I think he went off the track. Grosjean is struggling. I'm not sure I made a good choice. And Grosjean went off the track. These pit stops are brutal. I'm gonna have to change my car setup. Those pit stops are killing me. You can see I'm a lot more quiet on this one, so I'm trying to figure out what I need to do to get better result. Grosjean went off the track again. And watch, I'll probably go off the track again, too. I can't use Grosjean. That's embarrassing. That is embarrassing. Oh, Grosjean, you are horrible. That race right there is going to put me in jeopardy of qualifying. It's already been 15 minutes. Okay, so I made a driver. Actually, I made two driver changes. I switched in Giovinazzi and Daniel Kvyat. Kvyat's fuel management is a little squishy, but. And Giovinazzi's consistency could be better. There's nothing that does consistency. I guess the corners would be consistency. Okay. Well, anyway. We are at Melbourne. You saw the last race was an embarrassment. What was that, 23 points? Okay, we found ourselves a match. We are going racing. I changed my drivers and I changed my setup. I believe I had the laser lock and the Zen, and I changed that to the turbulence and the X1, and that took almost a second off my pit stops. My drivers still qualify in the back, but they both are able to pass. So once again, we always give a boost off the line. And Kvyat is losing spots. Okay, well, I'm not sure if I made my car better. I'm really not sure if these drivers are any better, but Grosjean was at the back, so I guess you can't get any worse than being at the back. I got my pit stops down to less than 4 seconds. Drivers are off. See if we can gain any positions. Have them come in for the pit stops. It doesn't look like anyone's making any moves. Yeah, I think the hard strategy might would have been the way to go. Guys are out there on hards. This is not looking good at all. was good to see my rival put hards on. That at least gives me a chance to beat my rival, but I am not looking good for getting that many points. Am I able to? Yeah, I'm able to make some moves, finally. Okay, looks like I might be able to score a little bit of points, but I still got another pit stop coming up. So my pit stops are about 3.5 seconds. I could have got more power and more aero. It would have cost me a 5 second pit stop. And the last race, you could see I got passed in the pits. Which is not good. Okay, so it looks like I'm going to be top 5, top 10. That's respectable. That's a lot better than my first race. Okay, I got third. And seventh, yes. Yeah, so you can see that second, I would have came in fifth and probably 18th. Well, that'd be 2 seconds I'd have to add. I'm switching over to George Russell because the next race has a 90% chance of rain. So these are my wet drivers, Russell and Kvyat. I got a race crate. Alright, we found a match, we're going racing. Said a 90% chance of rain, so it should pretty much be raining the whole. Okay, awesome. Russell needs help with his fuel. So I get to use my standard my standard strategy, which is 2.5 laps on slow. And then the rest of the time, we're going to be on full power. So if you guys ever want to know the best way to play this game, if this is your first time watching my video, you always want to start slow. As soon as the race starts, you go to low power, and you're just cruising around at the beginning, letting the other guys sort themselves out. If you got a driver with good defending, you'll notice he'll keep a lot of cars lined up behind him, and the gap will open ahead of him. As soon as you give your driver full power, he's going to close that gap. So it's not like you're really missing out on any time, but what that does is it allows you to use full power for the majority of the race. So if you watch, you will notice I'm coming up on the end of lap 2. I don't appear to be a threat to anyone. Look how far ahead his Grosjean is. But I know his Grosjean doesn't do good in the rain. There goes Kvyat. There goes Russell. So they are going to go around. And on the end of lap 4, we are going to pit. So his Kvyat is a better driver than my Russell, but my Kvyat is a better driver than his Grosjean. Ooh, that's a long pit stop for Grosjean. His Kvyat is staying out. Don't quite understand that. As you notice, Kvyat is slowly closing in on Grosjean. And his Kvyat's tires are about to go bald, which is really going to cost him. That might be the race. Yeah, I don't know if this Kvyat's going to be able to make up that many spots, but we'll see. This is a close race. Oh man, this is Yeah, he got me. He got me. I was not able to get far enough ahead. But 4th and 10th, I'll take it. It's a nice paint scheme. So as you guys notice, I don't win that often with this account. So I guess I should probably use this account more, since a lot of you new guys are wondering how to handle it. As you're seeing, I am not winning every time. Okay, I made another driver change. I think I'm going to stick with Russell. I might have to use boosts, which is the self-control, which will help me with his tire and mostly his tire. It's probably the same with Kvyat. Alright, we found a match. We're going racing. Is this 8 lap? Well, my drivers are evenly matched. The heck? Okay, shoot, I didn't know I couldn't give them both the same one. And I gave the wrong one to the wrong one. Oh man. Okay. Yeah, I messed that up. I gave the tire to the wrong guy. Okay, you guys might hear the sound effects, but I cannot. Is 8 laps. Okay, if I can go around with 66% tires, that means I can go 3 laps. We're going to be a little bit short. So I'm going to use my pit stop now. Okay, so we used our pit stops early, but we are going to the end, which means we're probably gonna have to take that last turn with bald tires. Okay, we got a top three. Top 3 and a top 10. Ooh, shoot. KVAT lost a spot. Did have enough fuel to go to the end. Russell's gonna have to cruise a little bit early. But he's in first, so we can have him cruise now. So we are double top 5. Can we get a double podium? Man, look at Kvyat go. His tires are gonna go pretty quick though. Oh. Alright, he lost his tires right there at the end. First and fourth, I'll take it. Yeah, 45 points. It's a good score. All right, we found a match. We're going racing. Seems like everyone I race has 1472 stars. Okay, we're back in China, and I'm still starting in the back. Okay. Should give them both really good tires. Okay, so we are looking good. Sorry about the jumpiness of the video. Okay, so we are pretty much going to cruise the first relapse. Okay, so it's moving up. Okay, so we are going to drop. Okay, look at Russell go. He's staying on the track, unlike Grosjean. At Russell go. Okay, so we're both up in the top 10. Kvyat just went off the track. Boom, go. And then third out in fifth. In an eighth, out in 13th. Okay. Okay, go. There you go. So I'm gonna try and slow them down on that one turn where they keep going off the track, try and help them out. Man, look at George Russell go. Can I get it? Okay, Russell's up into first. His tires are gonna go right about now. We're going to get first and sixth, which is doable. Wait, is that first and fifth? Oh, I like it. Okay. Okay, so you guys got to see me make parts changes. I didn't actually show you the process where I stripped everything down to the basic part and started fitting them to see which one gave me the most bonus per part. But that's what I had to do. Let me know if you'd like to see a video of that. Alright, we found a match. We're going racing. Do you think I'm racing the guy or the girl in that picture? Okay, ooh, wait. Did we get it? Okay, awesome. Phew. Wow, both my drivers are starting at the back. Okay, so the race has started. Russell's moving up. I've never seen anybody pass that many people on the first lap. Oh, we got another one. That tire isn't what I thought it was for Kvyat. All right, Russell's looking good. Kind of within striking distance of Perez, but he's not going to be able to make that many passes on this track, even though he just made a bunch. Will we start 22nd and 23rd? Okay, here we go. Did you see how his driver was able to pass me in the pits? How was that possible? See, now I give him full power, Russell can't pass. We are way in the back. There goes Kvyat. Oh, really? Well, there goes my chance to catch up. This is the weakest part of the whole game. I don't even know why they have it in, because look, number one is ahead of the pace car, he's gone. That's who the fucking safety car is supposed to be catching, is the number one car. But all he's doing is slowing us up. Am I not bad enough? Dude, I'm already in the back and you're slowing me down? I wish they would fix this. There goes my chance to qualify. After all that work, they throw this at me, which is bogus because I have no control over it, and the whole safety car mechanic just is so out of whack. I wish they would just do away with it because it doesn't work. Why is a safety car in this game? Can anyone tell me that? What's the whole point of that? All right, we found a match. We're going racing. I got three races left, 8, 9, and 10. Looks like I might still be able to qualify, depending on how these races go, but I gotta score good. If I keep qualifying at the back, I don't know, man. Especially if another safety car comes out. Jeez, the hell is that all about? Here we are at the back again. I don't understand why I'm being matched up like this. I can sense frustration. Seriously. This is embarrassing. I'm not gonna make it, dude. I am not gonna make it. This is rough. Back in last. Yeah, I'm not going to make the cut. It just doesn't make any sense that in some races I'm starting in the teens, and then, like, in the key races of the series, they have me starting, like, dead last. I don't get it. I'm not gonna make it. Oops, sorry about that. So I found a boost. I found a boost that might help more, and it's the downforce one. So I might need to swap the downforce to Russell. Okay, so again, we're just obviously just cruising at the beginning. So we have 5 laps. We don't have enough fuel. Just a little bit short. So we are going to wait until there. Now, Russell is mired in the back, so I don't know if he's going to be able to pass. I mean, he was doing a lot of moves on other tracks, but not so much when I gave him full power. That's going to hurt. Move all the way up to 12th and watch this pit stop. Watch that pit stop. And I have a good rating for my braking down, mind you. They just do not want me to cut it, dude. I'm not gonna make it. My drivers are practically even matched. How is one all the way up there and the other all the way back here? That shouldn't happen. If I make it to the next round, I will be extremely fortunate because I don't think I'm scoring enough points to cut it. All right, we found a match. We're going racing. Okay, so we are going to give him downforce. And we are going to give him that. Okay, at least this is a reasonable start for once. Okay, I was racing last night and I had this one race with a guy, I can't remember his name, but he actually used these things down here, and when he sprung his trap and he knew it was going to work, he hit me with one of those, and I managed to battle back and catch up, but then at the last pit stop, he was gone. And I'm going to show you the strategy that I think he ran. I was running a 3-3-2. And he ran a 3-2-3. And when he sprung that trap on me, he was gone. And I didn't catch it until the end of the race. But immediately when I knew, you know, because I saw the pit stop. And I was like, why is he pitting there, and why, like, I caught up to him. It was like how beating this guy started, but I passed him on this third lap. I passed him on this third lap, and then he passed me on the next lap, and he was just gone. Because where I was going slow for four and a half laps, he was only going slow for three. So whoever you were, thank you. I appreciate the lesson in humility. Yeah, because it was like on this lap he was making passes, and I was like, how are you passing? Like, I don't know what your strategy is. But you can see my Kvyat's making moves. And Russell's moving up as well. It's like when this pit stop happened, he was gone by the time I came in, and we started real close to each other, and I was like, oh shoot, I'm in trouble. And both his drivers finished ahead of mine. When I come by, you can see I'm going to be just a few short. So my tires are going to run out up here at that last sharp turn of the lap. But Russell will be so far ahead, it's not going to matter. Kvyat's tires are bald. You can see dudes catching up. Barely held on to two. If you didn't notice, I was tapping the full power. I didn't care if I ran out of gas. I didn't want to slow down because he definitely would have caught me. That might have saved my chances of moving on. And I got one last race. All right, we found a match. We're going racing. Okay, I normally don't use boost, but I need the boost. I'm sorry. Once again, we are at the back. Yeah, you don't want your driver to be on the outside. Because it's funny, he goes from outside to outside. Okay, so I'm gonna have to bring one of them in. So I'm gonna bring in George Russell. Okay, and Kvyat is coming in. And boom. We are off. Wait, Russell is supposed to wait a lap. No, he did wait a lot. Never mind. Pit stop soft. Pit stop soft. I was just getting ready to say, as long as we stay on the track, we'll be okay. I think I needed that mistake to happen because of my part being broken. Yep, perfect. Man, did you see that move by Russell? That was real smooth. Oh, good. Kvyat pulled the same move. All right, I got one guy up into the top 10. Good move, Kvyat. Okay, so I managed to get up into 8th. Oh wait, I still got another lap. Russell just went off. Go, 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 go. Cool. 2 top 10s. I'll take it. I will take it. I think I might qualify with that. I don't know. I still don't think I scored enough points. But anyway, that was a battle. That's the Chinese Grand Prix opening round. I'm sorry it's a long video, but I wanted to cover it all in one video because otherwise it would come out in 4 videos the way it was coming out before. So, yeah, you guys got to see me really stink up race number one. You also got to see me do some driver changes, some part changes, some more part changes, and I think I came up with a pretty good setup. So if you guys are of the same level, there's a setup you can use. And there's still a bunch more people to play. So, I don't know, dude. I don't think I'm going to cut it this time. If all these guys play, I don't think I'm going to cut it. Anyway, that was my opening round. If you guys liked the video, hit a like, subscribe. Any comments or questions, leave them down below. I try to answer as many comments and questions as I can. And I will see you guys, hopefully, for the next round. Until then, a hooey ho. Sorry, bonus footage.